back, guys. Got a tractor in the shop. Having a heck of a time getting this front axle assembly away from the motor. Because there's two bolts right there I can't get an impact on. And then I put an extension on the impact to get it on. And then the impact don't have enough power to break it free. So.
Just don't know where I'm at. Should be a little plate on the timing thing, so like take the injection pump off. For that to get broke, I already broke the lift pump up. Lift pump didn't work that great, but. I think there's supposed to be rocks in there. Not breaking free. Oh no, I did break the injection pump right here. Dang it. That just gets a little bit back, I don't know. Yeah, I better get the injection pump off. Next thing we're gonna do is crack the injection pump. I mean, it has a little crack, that little part broke off, but that's easily fixable. But if anything else cracks, we're gonna have a lot more issues. That is for sure. I need a little tool because they cleaned it. It's been a while since I used the little shop stool. There could be a sound wave coming out. I did not at the top. I did not see the double foot going up at the top. Seems like it up. This one has to break it free. And I want to clean around the area so I don't end up stripping the button there. That'd be a bad day.
And it's wrong.
It's wrong.
And this is probably wrong. Got that bolt out. It might be able to move now. Hopefully I get it to move. I hate when things don't go. What the issue is, that's my fault, guys. That is totally my fault. That's a human error right there. It's double nutted all the way around. That's why it's been giving me such a crap. I didn't even see that because of the oil. The oil's in there. But I want to get this injection pump off. The chain keeps slipping because it's so oily, and then the motor drops and slams. And I mean, it's clean oil on it, but I don't have a crane, and I don't have an engine point. No. This injection pump off because they're like, I think it's aluminum. If it's aluminum, it'll be pretty easy to fix that little piece of that on. Fight me. hooking the injection pump off a long time ago. What about this one? I hate when you don't have right. No, too small. It's too small or too big. Never the size you need. So wait. It's gonna be ridiculous. The day in the life. Yeah, I don't know if there's supposed to be rocks inside the injection pump, but it is what it is. to see what the heck I'm doing. These have not been off. So this is a, she went quite a long time on her. She was really hard to put when you went long for short. One of the lines on the tractor dropped and it cracked. One of the metal lines. So I'll go weld that up, see if I pick that. Yeah, I don't think there's supposed to be dirt and grass inside the block, but what happens when you have that help? So what cracked is this little part right here, but I'll just weld that little part back on. I want to see if I can get this part off. I'm going to take the cover off. I think it's... We'll have to pop a couple bolts out, pull this cover off, and do some more things. Go get it. Just Hey.
Still slick as still slick as snot in here. See what happens. There it went. There we go. Get him. Pry bar. Where is this damn tractor that I'm fighting with?
know what's going on, but the gap between the pulley and the engine is getting bigger. Either it's pushing the cover to the block, which I don't know why it would, but I'm taking the bolt off the bottom, or it's and get off of there. Hammer.
buy a pulley puller for that. Can't get that off. And then I'll get the cover on. And plus I need to put it. I might just apply some paper bottom bolts because by the time I get to them, they're gonna be some messed up. So where the heck is the hammer? Oh no. I don't know.
What? I want to thank everyone for watching. Wasn't really that much of a video. I mean, worked on tractor, but felt like I got nothing done really. So hit that subscribe button if you haven't. Like, share, comment, you know, situation. And hopefully next video, we're pulling that pulley off an engine separated from the front axle and frame there. Oh, besides, before I go, I did find some good news.
There you got that. So, I pulled the tires off, right? And I ain't gonna be able to do it, but from right there all the way to both sides, turn. So that means that someone probably just took out the hub stuff in there. So we just need to get the gear or whatever goes in there. And then probably electric solenoid. And I'm pretty sure four got to fit. Because there's been a couple times that I wish I had the four guy on it. When it's done, it's gonna be one bad mouthful.
And take you guys over to the tractor right now. And back, I take all this stuff off. Oh, there's a screwdriver. I take all this stuff off and gotta pull the fenders, I'm gonna pull the roof, gonna pull the cage. I gotta figure out how to fix the fenders. I don't want to get new fenders, but I might have to. There's this, and here's where a line broke. We broke a line right there. And we broke a line. Don't mind the transmission case is for me. That's what happened. And then we broke a line on this tape right here, which I think might be good. And then, of course, crushed a clutch lever. That wasn't good. But I think we should. I think I might just be able to cut that off. Yeah, cut that off. Work it and then weld it back on, and it should be good. I don't think the lever itself's been. I just think the pedal's twisted. So. And got all this to disassemble because I'm going to paint everything, start washing and stuff. But might have another sponsor. Well, that's good. They're, I won't say their name yet, but hopefully they sponsor me because they'll help out a lot. But, yeah. So, alright. Gonna end the video. Thanks for watching.